Today I'm taking up four questions we've been asked about fall protection. It's another Toolbox Talk. My name is Ben, and this is the Lifting and Rigging Channel. Today I'm answering your questions about fall protection. Remember, you're the lift director here. If you have a question that you want answered, drop it in the comments below. First question, can I use a swivel hoist ring as my anchor point when tying off? Well, the simple answer is no. We can get into the complexity of how some lifting points and swivel hoist rings do not have the proper safety and design factor built into them that is required. But simply put, most swivel hoist rings are not designed for fall protection. They are designed for lifting gradually. Many manufacturers specifically mention within their user recommendations that they do not recommend using their swivel hoist rings for fall protection applications and advise against shock loads. A fall is a shock load. Here are a few quotes from some manufacturers. All caps, do not apply shock loads. Always lift gradually. Another, we haven't designed our products with fall protection in mind. We do not recommend our hoist ring for fall protection. Some manufacturers do not specifically advise against it and have instructions on how to use their product in a horizontal lifeline assembly properly. There are lifting or swivel anchorage points that can be used for fall protection. When looking for a swivel anchorage point for fall protection, you need to look for the points that have been designed specifically with fall protection in mind and comply with the applicable standards. We must always comply with the manufacturer's recommendations for use when using any product. I highly recommend having a qualified person advise you on how to best install a fall protection system. There is a lot more to consider than just having an anchorage point, including fall distance, swing, weight, etc. Mazzella installs and supplies engineered fall protection systems, and we have very knowledgeable experts who can help guide you through your fall protection needs. Can you have two lines connected to one anchor point for extra security? You can't have two lines connected to one anchor point for security. If using two lines, one would have to be primary and the other secondary. Each line would need its own anchor point. An example of this is rappelling window washers or rock climbers. They are using equipment specifically designed to have a two-line system. But again, they have a primary and secondary line with their own anchor points. What is the minimum kilonewtons a carabiner has to be? 24 kN or kilonewtons is the equivalent of 5,400 pounds, which is the typical minimum. The weight requirements is 5,000 pounds compliant to the OSHA standard, unless the manufacturer of the carabiner specifically specifies a load rating. Can I attach a lanyard to my self-retracting lifeline to get extra reach in my fall restraint system? Only if your fall protection system is specifically engineered for that application. You cannot attach a snap hook to another snap hook, as unintentional disengagement could occur. Some systems can be specifically designed or engineered to accommodate a different attachment point at the end of your lifeline. But unless the manufacturer designed your system for that purpose, you cannot tie a lanyard to an SRL or multiple lanyards together by connecting the carabiners or snap hooks. If you're looking for more information on any of these topics, check out the links in the description. We also have a ton of information on anything fall protection related in our learning center at mazzellacompanies.com. Not to mention that we offer fall protection training, engineered lifeline systems, and soft goods such as harnesses and retractables. If you have a question of your own, drop it in the comments. My name is Ben, and stay safe out there.